Recording. Yes. Okay, so guys, we have taken the delivery of the Honda Highness CB350, and I'm very late for work. This is our bike, first startup. I don't think there's fuel in it. We'll have to get fuel. Okay, first startup of our bike. I'll have to adjust the mirrors. They're not very wide, but you know, you get decent visibility out of them. Okay, so, well, for today, this is my crew, this is my cousin, this is my brother. We are leaving. All right, bye bye. Okay, man, smooth bike. The tank recesses are really nice. Feels nice to hold the tank. It's wide and it's tapered, so it's nice. Linear power on the bike, second gear. Sounds a little at idle, at such slow speeds, thump is not there. Easy to take U-turns on. Let's see what this Enter does. Okay, just up and down is working, I guess. This is the battery voltage, 14.4. Range, 28 kilometers. I love the fact that this motorcycle displays the range. Slick shifting gearbox, very easy clutch, very light clutch. I think this motorcycle comes with a slip and assist clutch. Seat is wide, comfortable to sit on. So we will get to know how this motorcycle feels in the city to ride. Oh, braking is good. Stops without any drama. It has power, the brake. Oh, nice. I like the sound. Oh, I do like the sound. Very slick shifting. A very thumpy engine. Very, handling is nice. Very maneuverable, filterable. Oh, this is good. I like it. I already like this bike. I've been on it for a minute and I like it. I was worried that, you know, the instrument console, the digital part of the display would be really small. It is small, but it's legible. I can see, I can read everything clearly. Let's see what else it shows. Trip A, average 12.5, it says. I don't know, that's probably how many kilometers this has done. What is this, 54.2? I don't know. Oh, this could be a real-time mileage indicator. We will need to buy fuel. Man, this is a very slick riding motorcycle. Yeah, this is a very comfortable bike. My feet are in a very, you know, slightly forward position than the Interceptor. I like it. This will make for a good long distance bike too, I think. It's very beautiful. I'm so proud of having this Honda badge over here. Hey, mirrors are not vibrating. I like it. I really like it. Nice. Guys, this is not a review, okay? This is just first impressions. I'll just say whatever that comes to my mind. And I'm kind of glad that, you know, I'm riding it in traffic right now, because that's where this motorcycle is going to spend most of its time. A lot of guys are going to take it to the highway, do 0 to 100 runs, etc. Whatever, man, this is not that kind of motorcycle. you're not going to do those things on this bike on a day-to-day basis. So yeah, it doesn't go any further. Oh, it does. Okay. Very easy to turn. Thumpy motor. Very slick gearbox. Yeah, very, very slick gearbox. Brakes. You know, even though, you know, the brakes take time to bed in, the tires take time to, you know, perform to their optimum level. These are brand new tires. I like it. I really like it. It's torquey, you know, it's the torque is linear, but it's there. So let's see if we are in the fifth, how low can we ride in the fifth, okay? Let's let the speed drop down. Yeah, this is not, it wants me to give it some gas. Yeah, it doesn't like it. It doesn't like it. Nope, it's not liking it. I think you have to be at least about 60 in the fifth for the motorcycle to... Okay, fuel pump. Where is the indicator? Okay. Let's get fuel. Over there, motorcycles. So what I'll do is, I'll ride it till home and I'll add some fuel again. But the problem is home is not that far away, so doing a fuel efficiency test on it doesn't make any sense. I love it. It's just classy, this motorcycle. Brake pedal, easy to reach. Gear shifter, easy to reach. Beautiful. Beautiful motorcycle. Grips, comfortable, nice to hold on to. They're not adjustable, the brake and the clutch lever. Yeah, hazard lights. But yeah. Oh, can I turn the traction off? So it says total 8 kilometers, battery voltage 13, range it's not showing. Okay, trip B, trip A, total 8. Bhaiya, card chal raha hai? Haan, zara tank full kar do, normal petrol. First time opening this. Okay. देखते हैं कितना फ्यूल आता है. Guys, I'm sorry, I don't know if it's a 12 liter 14. It looks bigger than 12. Must be a 13 or a 15 liter fuel tank. I don't know. Again, you know, this is not about specifications. I do not know the specifications. I only care about how the motorcycle feels to ride. And it, so far, it feels damn good. 13.24. ऊपर तक भरो ना कितना आता है भैया? कितना आया? Oh man, 17 liters. 17 liters. Insane. Oh man, just a light bike. Something about light bikes, you know. Seat is very generous. I'm not the lightest guy around. I weigh about, well, actually I weighed 79.9 and I came from the gym today. So yeah, so I'm about 80 kilos, 5'10 and a half. So bike fits somebody like me, my frame, very well. And this is a bike you don't need risers on or anything. You know, I wanted to go to GFR on the bike today. I don't have time. Had Honda given me the bike on time, I would have gone. Okay, so man, the bike doesn't, it doesn't, in the fifth gear it doesn't really want to go. So if you're from, you know, low speed, let's say I'm at 60 and I open the throttle, it's taking its own time to accelerate. So the roll-on speed in fifth is not that great. Maybe 5th is just an overdrive. It doesn't have a 6th. I think, I'm sure it doesn't have a 6th, but let's try. Yeah, no, there's no 6th. I think I'll have to discuss it with the Honda guys. Probably they'll tell me that, you know, after the first service it'll improve, but I wasn't very impressed with the roll-on figures. In the fifth, I just didn't feel like the motorcycle was going anywhere. Engine braking is really good. So if you keep it, you know, in the power band, you feel like the motorcycle's going, but if you cross the power band, which I think is, it comes very early on this bike. I don't know, I think I read that the power comes in at about 3000 RPM, the torque comes in at 3000 RPM. I don't know. I really don't know. I should have read specifications. It's too excited to just pick up the bike. So yeah, it feels enough, feels stocky. But not in the higher, if you're revving it high, it didn't feel like that. Probably, you know, if I ask people, they'll say, oh, wait for the first service, this, that, whatever. Didn't feel it. That's what I think. Range. Let's go to range. I'm interested in seeing what range it says that this can go. .367 it says. I'm sure it'll go up. So in the city at, you know, 50 in third, let's see, 50 in fourth. Again 50 in fifth. It doesn't like it. It does not like speeds of 50 kilometers an hour in fifth. And now let's just open the throttle to see how it feels. You get that typical bullet sound. The suspension is tuned slightly on the harder side. Okay, now again, you know, I feel like the motor is spinning up. It's making power. Oh, lovely sound. Lovely sound. I think, you know, Honda has made a great alternative to the Royal Enfield Classic 350. I wonder what Royal Enfield would do with a Meteor. They already pushed the launch of the Meteor back. You know, so that it doesn't coincide with the Honda. Oh, the suspension was slightly stiff here. It could also be, look guys, let me tell you something. When I say that the suspension is stiff and the power is slightly low, that's because this morning I was riding my Tiger 1200. The Tiger 1200 has the cushiest of suspension and it has crazy amounts of power. So keep that in mind when I say these things. You know, it's not like I'm coming from a Royal Enfield Classic 350 and saying that there is no power or there is no suspension's not too soft. The sound is addictive. Motorcycle's easy to throw around. Okay, now it's going. Yeah, I like it. Man, the gearbox is so smooth, so slick. Wow. Wow. Smooth bike, no vibrations. No vibrations. Is this a joke? You know, I don't want to sound like a fanboy. I'm not. I don't really care about any manufacturer. I just care about the product. So no matter if a manufacturer has, you know, 5,000 amazing products, if that product that, you know, the one that I want, if that is not really up to the mark, it doesn't work. I'm happy to say this does. Visibility is good, yeah, in the mirrors. I thought these stalks are too short. They're too in, too narrow. Arey, I'm very happy with this bike. So guys, you know, this motorcycle cost us 2,18,000 something and some change on road Delhi. This is one of the first motorcycles from the first lot to be delivered. So we got it from the Honda Big Wing showroom in Gurgaon. Now there is a problem with this motorcycle, in a sense, in the way it's, you know, being sold in the market. It's only being sold at Honda Big Wing stores. Now, while I understand that Honda says that, you know, we only have 4 stores in the country right now and by March we'll get to 50 stores, but yeah, people want to buy the bike. If there is no Honda Gold, Big Wing store in Delhi, people have to come to Gurgaon to buy this motorcycle. That's not cool, man. What if somebody, today there was a person who had come from Jaipur to buy the bike. This shouldn't happen, you know. But what I understand is, the reason, well, what I feel is that Honda is selling this at the Big Wing store is because, you know, you have to earn money. These big showrooms, they're not about volumes. They don't sell a lot of motorcycles. So sustaining such an expensive showroom, it needs money. They need sales, and this is a motorcycle that will get you those sales. But you know, Honda, you might say that, oh, we're not competing with the Royal Enfield, but let's not kid ourselves here. You are. This motorcycle was made solely to break the market of Classic 350. Classic 350 is one of the most popular motorcycles in our country in the 300 to 500 range. I think it probably is the most, is the highest volume earner in that category, and this motorcycle is aimed solely at that. So if a person cannot go to a showroom right now in their small town and buy this motorcycle, then I don't know, man. That's not right. That's not how it should be. But then again, I understand, Honda, you have to earn money. I'm sure you would have thought about it and come up with this decision. Anyway, that's not for me to judge. I'm just enjoying your product. Okay guys, but you know, while I've talked about this bike and said mostly positive things, there is one thing that I don't understand, and I asked Honda. Honda officials, top Honda officials who were at the showroom, they spoke to me. However, I will not reveal which official told me what. I'm not going to name them, but you know, I asked them, why is it that this charger is a USB Type-C? Now, who in India can say that they have a USB Type-C to Type-C cable? Nobody. If somebody has an iPhone, the iPhone doesn't come with, you know, a lightning port at one end and a USB at the other. It's stupid to have something like this. So you have to have a converter first. Honda, this is a big miss. You want this motorcycle to do volumes in India and you make a move which, you know, is not even conducive for somebody in India. Now, I can say that I have a USB Type-C to Type-C cable, but who else does, really? It's big flaw. If you had the international market in your mind, which they told me that this is going to be an export model also, even then, a regular USB is what this motorcycle needed. Big miss. I still don't know how to, you know, turn the traction control off, which is called some torque control or whatever in this motorcycle. I'm not feeling the need to, I can't tell if, you know, traction control is on or off, or if it's kicking in. Well, we're riding at very silly pace over here. Like, silly in the sense that, you know, easy 20-30 kilometers an hour. Let's see if I can. Let me see if I can filter from here. Easy, man. Lovely. Range 524 kilometers. 17 liter fuel tank. Comfortable seat. Feet reach the ground easy. Soft grips. Good quality tactile feeling switch gear. This is the, that's how Triumphs come. I don't know how, I've not ridden a lot of Hondas, the big ones, so I don't know how they are. Front tires are 19, so it'll roll easily. Rear is 18. Again, you know the sizes of the Classic. I think this has a long wheelbase, this motorcycle, so this will be very stable on the highway. Tomorrow morning I'm going to take it to the Gurgaon Faridabad road and ride it over there and see how it does in, you know, corners. Obviously I won't ride it fast. This is a new bike. This is not even mine, guys. This is not my motorcycle. This is my uncle's motorcycle. He bought it. He wanted to buy a Java 42. And as soon as he, you know, booked his Java, I got his Java cancelled. I got to know and I told him, what the hell are you doing? Why would you get a Java over this? For people who, you know, ride their motorcycles day in, day out, city commuting, you need something that's reliable. Honda is that. I hope this motorcycle turns out to be reliable. Simple engine, okay? Very simple engine. I think it must be a two-valve head. I don't know. Bike's not heating. I am wearing shorts. I'm not feeling anything. Arey. Must yaar, this is good. I love the sound, man. I love the sound. I'm finally understanding why people talk about the Royal Enfield thump and they love it, and you know they wouldn't have anything else. Can you hear it? I don't know if you guys can hear it. I most certainly can, and I'm enjoying it. ABS doesn't kick in that quickly, which is good. I love the fact that they've provided Nissan master cylinder and Nissan calipers. I did not get the time, or I actually had the time, but I didn't check what is the caliper at the rear. It could be Nissan again. Amazing. This motorcycle is a little difficult to keep under 50. Or maybe I'm just used to digital speedometers now. Arey, thump yaar. Beautiful. And you know, the oh, that's a 750 GS? Yeah. No, sweet camera. So, indicators, etc. They are LED. The headlight is LED. The tail light is LED. And this motorcycle only costs 10,000 rupees more than the Royal Enfield Classic 350 top model. I mean, what else do you want? Yeah. Look, I've not ridden the Classic 350, the very recently, the latest iterations. I've spent some time on the Classic 500 of my friend Ankur. Aray, just using the rear brake to stop. Oh, it just turns like a charm, yaar. Turns like a charm. Can't feel the weight. BMW guys really pushing it. And it's such a good looker, this bike. Such a good looker. The console, it looks premium, okay? Just super premium. Yeah, suspension is hard. Slightly tuned on the stiffer side. For the city, I believe, you know, for people who are going to ride it in the city, maybe the suspension could have been slightly softer. Just a tad, just like 10% softer. But for people who are going to ride this motorcycle enthusiastically, and I hope people do not ride this motorcycle enthusiastically, it's not that kind of motorcycle. It surely can, but it's not that kind of motorcycle. They will like it. I think it's going to handle well. So when you just open the throttle and go, this bike has some go. So this bike will be with me for a week. I'm going to test it inside out. You know, guys, ask me in the comments whatever you want to know about this motorcycle. Whatever that you want to know about this motorcycle. However, I'm not going to do 0 to 100 runs. I'm just going to ride this motorcycle from the perspective of a person who's going to use it on a daily basis. Yeah, I shouldn't have done that. Well, is it ours? I don't know. No, it's theirs, yeah. I think I'll just go, yeah. Let's test the horn. Where is it? I can't. Oh, yeah, here. Horn is. So the indicators are placed lower, the horn is placed higher. That is new. Not used to it. Okay, horn is good. I just got an X-Pulse Saturday. That horn is shitty. Do not honk, guys. Try avoiding, honking as much as possible. But if you need it, yeah, okay. Takes time to figure out. This is a good horn. Fucking nice, yeah. So I just got, pushed up from the seat. So light, so light. I think the indicators, they have DRLs. Probably. Five 75 kilometers range. 590 with the throttle like this. So realistically, it'll at least do 450-500. I'm really liking this motorcycle, man. I'm home. Yeah, without keeping the feet down. An impossible task on my street triple. On the Tiger, I've done it. On the street triple, no. Okay, now you guys will call me crazy when I say this, but let's take a quick size comparison with the Tiger. So I close it. Yeah, DRLs. Lovely looking LED light at the front. It's not a small bike. The Tiger is one of the biggest bikes that you'll see, the 1200. This is not a small bike by any means. Beautiful looking. What a lovely color. Love the chrome. I think a slightly more mature audience is going to appreciate the styling of this bike. Somebody who's seen motorcycles in the 90s, in the 80s, in the 70s. Maybe they'll appreciate this bike a little more than, the 20-year-olds, because most of them, I'm sorry if I'm generalizing, but they're the Duke-loving and, the sports bike-liking guys. This is perfect for somebody who wants a premium commuter, somebody who, wants an easy-going tourer which gives good fuel economy. The frame. So it's a cradle, it's a single pipe that sort of splits into two. Okay. Yeah, comfortable bike. Let's see how easy it is to put on the center stand. Easy. Very easy. So three of my bikes are inside. So I'm not gonna take it inside. I'll just I'll park it over here for now, yeah. And then okay, let's also see how easy it is to pull and push around. Stand comes off like this. Easy to push. I love small bikes, man. I just love these small bikes. Let's lock it. And there you have it, guys. This is horrible. First and foremost, yeah, another con. Why the hell did Honda have to name it Highness? I know it's too, you know, because Royal Enfield, so Highness. But yeah, it's a stupid name. They should have just called it the CB350. Then this red badging, I hate it. I just hate it. It's ugly. It's unnecessary. It should have just said CB350, this little black thing over here. Other than that, look at this. Look at how wide this seat is. Enough place for a pillion. I don't know if somebody sits, you know, with, if a woman wearing a sari sits with both feet on one side. I don't know. I'll maybe later. Okay, let's see the rear caliper. Nissan single pot, twin pot over here. Man, I got no complaints. I got no real complaints about this bike. I can tell you 5 things that's wrong with the Tiger. I can't really tell you 5 things that's wrong with this bike right now. Wow. Okay, having said that, I'm gonna end this video. It's 5:35. I should have been at work at 3. But you know, new bike. Alright guys, have a nice day. Thank you. Bye-bye.